The lamina propria is in the subfield.
It's different than GI tract. For this, just remember
the Virginia Apgar Academy of Medical Educators has a variety of missions. Mainly, what we want to do is to support, encourage, motivate, and reward the outstanding educators that we have here at PNS. We can do that in a variety of ways by admitting the outstanding educators into our academy as members, signaling to the faculty that they have demonstrated excellence in a variety of areas, teaching, advising, mentoring, having curriculum innovation, leadership, scholarship. But we can also do that by providing education about teaching to the rest of the faculty through workshops, coaching, and a variety of other methods.
I'm extremely excited about the launch of the Virginia Apgar Academy. Teaching is an absolute cornerstone of what we do here at PNS. Teachers are the role models for our future physicians, both in the way they take care of patients, the way they do research. And I'm a strong advocate for the strongest possible teaching program and finding appropriate ways to reward and recognize people who are outstanding teachers. Just as we have ways of rewarding and recognizing people who do great research, teaching is an equivalent part of our mission. Here at the College of Physicians and Surgeons, we do lots of things. We have a huge clinical practice, an enormous research enterprise. But fundamentally, we're a medical school. And we teach people who are going to be the physicians of the future.
So these are all the ones that produce it. This is the channel.
Okay.
And what these cells are actually doing are modifying.
There is no higher calling in life than preparing the next generation of professionals.
Somebody on infliximab, methotrexate, prednisone with necrotizing granulomas. TB,
We do it by hopefully showing them the best ways to take care of patients, hopefully by showing them the best ways to move the field forward in terms of research. But we're a medical school. The Virginia Apgar Academy is the way we're going to recognize, reward, and mentor people to be the kinds of teachers that are the fundamental core of a great medical school.
Neutropenia, which it increases your neutrophil count, which it's like a...
Everyone can really benefit from learning about the science of teaching, learning about how to use objectives in teaching, learning about how to evaluate your teaching, how to be self-reflective about teaching, and how to use that information to continuously improve what you do as an educator.
There's twin studies which show increased concordance between monozygotic versus dizygotic twins, about 20% versus 1.5%.
Wow.
So it's pretty significant.
So that's pretty...
There's a lot of studies with like familial...
They just run clerkships with these patients. And then they were each asking questions about the case that interested them. I mean, that was great, the one I just listened to, because those students asked questions that I wanted to know the answers to, and they knew.
Ionamide, you want to use propranolol instead of atenolol to block the T4-T3 conversion.
Why? Oh, because you want to block that conversion.
One of the things that I've found most rewarding is going and watching other teachers. Every time I watch a wonderful teacher, I learn something new, and I'm hoping that we're going to evolve into a network of teachers constantly sitting in on each other's teaching and learning from each other, best practices, new things to do, exciting ways to engage students.
Is there anyone whose job it is?
Actually listed the percentages for what these complications were, but it was from a long time ago, it was from like the early 90s, so the percentages probably no longer apply with the risk still there.